The following opinions are solely those of BoatTEST.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTEST.com, and today I'm on a new boat from Robalo, the R242EX. Now, this takes the quality of the fishing boat, the 242, and turns it into a family boat, great for entertaining and having fun on the water. Let's take a look at how Robalo has done as I do a full features inspection and a performance evaluation. It's a 10-inch step up to the swim platform, and we have full walkability all the way across the transom. Reboarding ladder is over to the starboard side, and it's a four-step. The aft deck starts with wraparound seating, adding to the comfort level of the boat. We can sit people across the stern, into the corner, and notice we can also have a recliner facing forward. There's storage under the side seat, the center back seat, and under this seat, look at this, a 16-gallon live well, because Robalo correctly determined that it would be silly to take all of the fishing features out of a center console. It has the typical features of interior color blue, light, rounded edges, it's aerated, and the lid is gasketed all the way around. Just forward, the leaning post includes a 70-quart cooler, and notice how this one is held in place by a bar with a removable pin, so we can bring the bar up and slide the cooler out. There are no more chocks holding it into the deck, and in this manner, you can now take whatever cooler you want and put it into position here. You don't have to be married to this cooler. That's a voice of the customer response from Robalo. It also eliminates all of the holes in the deck for those chocks. As we move up, we've got a grab rail, four rocket launcher style rod holders, and another four up on the back of the hardtop. And of course, we also have two LED spreader lights. And we'll round out the fishing features with two combination rod and drink holders, one to each side, and two rod holders, one to each side, and three rod holders under the gunwale. There's a pad against the bulwarks to protect your reels, and I also appreciate that there's a tow rail underneath. The family features continue as we move forward. I notice we have bolsters wrapping 360 degrees around the boat, which is a great feature. Here they start out at 21 inches, top out at 27 inches, with the cap rail at a safe 28 inches. Fully forward, wraparound seating goes all the way across the bow, another seat just ahead of the console, and I like how there are removable seat backs, so we even add to the comfort level, and the grab handle is conveniently located. Of course, there's storage under all the seats. Here it consists of two 36-gallon fish boxes that have overboard drains, and there's a built-in cooler in between the two, fully forward. Under the aft seat back, there's clever dedicated storage for the table that can go up at the bow. We can lower the table, add a cushion, and make a full sun pad. And of course, with the cushions removed, we can create a casting platform, because remember, it's still a center console. Just behind and ahead of the console is the head compartment. It features dedicated storage for the two table pedestals, and there's an opening port light for ventilation. Taking a look at the helm, it starts at the top with a windshield made out of tempered safety glass, not acrylic. Two recessed storage areas on top of the console that are self-draining and a compass right in the center. I love the vinyl on the top of the dash. And on the panel itself, this can be populated with either one or two Garmin displays, 10-inch, Simrad 9-inch displays. And either way, they're going to be NEMA 2000 compatible, so they connect up to the engine, meaning we don't have to have gauges on the dash. It's all a glass helm. Push-button switches to either side are all lighted when activated. Stereo, auxiliary input, MP3 and USB inputs. There's a space in the middle that's convenient for putting your phone and another auxiliary plug just alongside that, then the trim tab controls. There are stainless steel drink holders to either side of the stainless wheel, and I love that there's a steering knob and it's all mounted, yes, to a tilt base. Down below, lockable glove storage, ignitions high enough outside the knee strike zone, and then the Yamaha engine controls. Below that, there are two levels of footrest so that we can use them while standing or sitting. And look at this nice helm seat, double wide, wrapped around on the sides, multiple tones of upholstery, custom embroidery, and the individual seats both have their own flip-up bolsters. And all of this is under the protection of the hardtop that includes an electronics box, two color courtesy lights, the supports are elongated and integrated into the console so they're not taking up side deck space, just on the back side, integrated handholds. Fully forward, there's a lift and lock latch that opens the hatch to the anchor locker. There's room in the back of the cleat for a windlass. A stainless steel anchor roller is just ahead on the bow. Washdown connection is on the left-hand side, and we have easy access to the road to both sides. At the walkthrough to the cockpit, there's a door, and just behind, we've got the main electrical panel with the battery switch. Also under the center cushion, there's a battery charger, a convenient storage shelf, rigging for the fuel tank and the batteries.
The Robalo 242 Explorer has a length overall of 24 feet, a beam of 8 feet 9 inches, and a draft of 35 inches. With an empty weight of 4,800 pounds, 45% fuel, and two people aboard, we had an estimated test weight of 5,609 pounds. With a 300 horsepower Yamaha F300 UCA turning a 15.5-inch 3-bladed Saltwater Series 2 prop, we reached our top speed of 46.3 miles per hour at 6074 RPM. Best cruise was measured at 3,500 RPM and 24.2 miles per hour. It was at that speed that the 8.1 gallon per hour fuel burn translated into 3 miles per gallon and a range of 375 statute miles, all while still holding back a 10% reserve of the boat's 140 gallon total fuel capacity. She came on plane in an average 3.5 seconds, accelerated to 20 miles per hour in 5.5 seconds, and 30 came and went in 8.2 seconds. The 242 is truly a pleasant boat to handle. She has good freeboard for offshore runs, but of course we had calm weather on our test day. Crossing wake shows a remarkably smooth transition with her generous bow flare producing minimal spray and virtually no hull slap. She's equally graceful in her turns, exhibiting just enough roll and gentle slide so that there's no tendency to get shoved to the outside of the turns. Basically, no matter how aggressive you get, there's just no making the ride uncomfortable. She's that forgiving.
So clearly we've got family comfort, the quality handling that we've come to expect from the brand, and the safety of an offshore center console all rolled into one with the R242EX from Robalo. And that is my full features inspection and sea trial. For BoatTEST.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.